Hello everybody, figured I'd give you guys an update on the Duranautic. We got a easy loader for her a couple weeks ago, got her all registered, working on the interior right now. Oh, had to build a little something up here, I could stick a light there, and I needed a little place for the anchor. This is some foam that they ship some fenders and stuff in to work, and it makes a nice cushion. It's pretty good stuff. This is a little battery box built, and it's also gonna work as a little backrest for this front seat. But you see the battery fits in there. I still gotta put some stainless eye screws down there so I can get a strap over it, just so it doesn't come up out of them pieces of wood there. Built these sides for it here because I needed something to mount some stuff to, like the fish finder, and I'm gonna drill some holes in here and here and there and there to make some cup holders. We put this seat together and made this back. Oh gosh, yeah, you see. And I'm using some paracord to support it. And I mean, that thing doesn't move, but it gives just a little to make it comfortable. And I mean, this might be a little bit of overkill, but that thing ain't going anywhere. I wanted it really strong because you're most likely you're going to be, you know, using this to get in and out of the boat. So it had to be pretty damn strong. And I could put all my weight on that without a problem. It doesn't even make a noise. And we built this backboard here. Pretty much just got it strapped in. I mean, the cooler's here. Got the fuel tank over here. And you can see there's just a ratchet strap hooked up under the seat, and it just holds everything this way. Holds this. This is solid as all hell. It ain't going nowhere. And the tail end of that thing, I could just use as a freaking tie strap. No big deal. But there you go. I got a couple more things to do, and then I'm going to take this whole thing apart and do all the cuts. I got to make little cuts there, and that's going to get extended to this side. And, you know, I don't know. I might just step that down right there. I haven't made up my mind yet, but it definitely needs something. I mean, it clears, but boy, she's close. She's real close. So I got to take this wood out right here just to make sure. But I mean, even if you're running it, you know, you can run it up there. What's the big deal? Okay, it still works, you know. Well, here she is. Once I get everything all cut out and sanded and ready for poly, I'll show you again. And then after that, we'll put her all back together, and I'll give you a little shot of it then too. Alright, see ya. Okay, we got bottoms and backsides of these things. Using the polyurethane stuff, we got this. We're trying this stuff out now on this stuff. And black cherry. It's a pretty cool color. Pretty nice. We got everything sanded down to 180. And we're getting ready this afternoon to put coat or two on top of this. I'm going to do one coat, see how it comes out, because I want a lot of the wood to show through. I think it looks really good, but I might want it a little, just a tad bit shinier than what it's ending up. It's supposed to be a semi-gloss, so I think it's going to take two coats, but I just put one good coat on everything that's underneath or getting sandwiched between something or something or something. But yeah, alright, we'll get back to you. Hey guys, we got the top sides and faces of all these done. Oh, drip. Oh, that's all right. These are all done. And I'll be getting them back to the boat tonight. And hopefully start putting this thing back together. All right, I'll get back to you. All right, guys. We got everything here. I think all my eggs are in one basket. And we're going to start putting this together. All this stuff is just basically laying in here because I just unloaded the truck and threw it in here. But we found these at the Fender. The only ones that had any kind of bench seat pad. My measurement is 34 inches between these two side pieces of wood. These things are 33 and a half. Unbelievable. And then they had these nice little stainless steel cup holders. They fit right in my 3-inch holes. Perfect. I'm not going to tell you how much all this cost. It was very expensive for what it is. But if you guys want to know how much this stuff is, you can look it up yourself. But we are in the process of putting all this back together. And I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. All right, I'll get back to you. All right, guys. We just finished up the tinny and got her home. Sorry, the neighbor's cutting the grass. We got all non-skid under those pieces of rug. There, I'm gonna mount another one over there, and up front here, we got a battery in here. We built all that box and the anchors and stuff can go up there. But yeah, that's it. Put cup holders in her. And let's see, we could probably get a good shot around. I don't know if we get the whole thing in there or not. Also, put some big tires and a 2-inch lift on the Toyota. So she's looking pretty good now. And there's the Duronautic. You're all done. Hey guys, I'll get back to you.